Hi, everybody. Thanks for stopping by. My name is FM Jellico, and you're watching the Defuge Challenge, episode 40.1 with Enfield Town FC. Places. I'm not sure, but I would highly suggest going back at least one episode to watch what was going on, if that is too much of a bother for you. Long story short, this is the last game of the season. It is the Vanarama playoff. Whoever wins goes up to League 2. We are playing AFC Wimbledon, who beat us 3 weeks ago. We are just coming off a win in the semifinals at Wrexham, where we won 4-1. The issue is the Wrexham game and the AFC Wimbledon game together in one episode are about 48 minutes long, because as this is the last game of the season, I also do an end-of-season review. And frankly, that's just too long to sit through. I'm a pretty patient guy when it comes to watching and listening to YouTube videos, even at work, and 45 to 50 minutes is just too long. 30 minutes... maybe 35 I can get away with. 45 to 50 minutes, no. And honestly, I left myself enough of a break once I realized how long the episode was going to be. I could take that original episode, chop it up into two pieces. So the Wrexham game is episode 40. The AFC Wimbledon game is going to be episode 40.1. And we are going to get that underway right now. The National League Playoff Final, Wembley Stadium, London. Enfield Town is the home team against AFC Wimbledon, the second and third place teams in the Vanarama. We are going with what got us here, the 3-4-3. Hilson goal, Elston, Meekings, and Ellisley as the defensive back three. Bentley, Grayson, Perry, and Allen as the midfield four. Ashton, Gordon, and Scott up top. On our bench, we have Wakely, Bamba, English, Hunt, and Robinson. Wimbledon is playing a 4-3-3 with Murphy in goal, Williams, Davies, Truman, and Davies as the defensive back four, Whiteman as the defensive midfielder behind Evans and Webb, Reedy and Best are the attacking mids with Nash up top as the striker. On their bench they have Stevens, Sangare, Coulson, Cope, and Junkins. Tom Ashton was out for 5 to 6 days, so he's not at full speed, but I think we'll be okay. Ashton with the goal. Over to Scott. Well, he loses it. Gets sent up to Reedy, who sends it forward. Nash breaking through, and he blasts one past Hilson near post. Minute 20 into the game. Hilson could have done a bit more with that. Grayson with the kick in. It doesn't look like I have my corner set up. I'll have to check that here in a little bit. Gordon to Grayson. And we lose it. Nash has it. Made the play on the ball and totally missed. Well, the nice thing there was that there was no one to cover that pass. Bentley up to Ashton. Up to Gordon. And Murphy with a nice block. Well, they looked right, but they certainly weren't looking right the way the players were standing on the pitch. Well, about a half hour in, we are making our comeback. Webb to Evans. Now Elston with the ball back to Hilson. Sends it up to Ellisley, who sends it towards Ashton, but it gets sent back to Perry by a Wimbledon player. Ellisley to Allen, and Allen tries splitting it to Gordon, but goes back to Murphy, who kicks it forward. Ellisley knocks it, but it goes right to Webb, who sends it back to Nash, and Hilson with a nice save. Corner kick to Wimbledon. And it's kicked wide by Evans. Evans has it. Up to Reedy. Sends it over. Meekings sends it back out. Best is there, and he slots it right past Hilson. Okay, 33 minutes in. Yes, Will Mark Nash. Now the defenders just clumped around the center. Come on, guys, we can get it back. One before halftime. Bentley. Grayson. And he's dispossessed. And Nash gets the open goal because Hilson... son of a... What the heck happened there? Oh, good God. And who was that? Meekings or is that Elston? Was Meekings. Made no effort. Okay, we're yelling. Unreal. I know it's Wembley. Come on. We've seen these guys before. Plus, they're without one of their best players. Todorov is out injured. My guys are just not getting to the ball. What is that? Nash with the shot? I mean, they get, like, right next to the ball and then, like, run away. It's like, oh, we can't go near the ball. Come on, guys, we need to start scoring here. Allen. Allen, he gives it away. Nash has it. Sends it in. Best is there to Webb. 4-0, 52 minutes in. Son of a gun. They're absolutely bossing us. There's no reason they should be. Grayson picked up a yellow. Look at that. That pass was just absolutely horrible. Perry's better than that. Can't be nerves. It's almost an old goal. Hilson ran away from the ball too. What the hell gives there? Nash. It's the outside, goes in. You know what? English is coming on for Grayson. Wakely's coming on for Meekings. Hunt is going on for Ashton, and he's moving to the center. Gordon's going to move out. And I think we may as well go to the overload. Allen sends it forward to Scott. Pass it. And Gordon with the goal. Nice. We get one back. Okay, three more, guys. Well, it wasn't Scott passing so much as it was a Davies slide tackle, sending the ball right to Gordon, but I'll take it. Bentley with the throw-in to English. To Hunt, back to English, over to Scott. Two goals in less than 2 minutes. Come on, guys. Come back. Come back. Oh, nice backheel pass. Now Nash has it. Feeds it to Reedy, and he taps it over Hilson into the goal. 5-2. Makes the comeback that much harder. Looks like he just lobbed Hilson. Let's see. Now Perry with the slide tackle. Sent it right to Reedy.
Nash is left all alone. I know he's being marked. I told him specifically mark him. Cope kicks it wide left. Minutes left. Bentley, the throw in, knocked away by Whiteman. Bentley gets it back. English sends it in, but it's knocked out. And Ellsley has it midfield. Sends it forward to Gordon, and he buries it. 5-3, 15 minutes left. And it was disallowed? Was he offsides? Son of a gun. They are being closed down. Good grief. English sends it forward. Can Scott get there? Not before Murphy can pick it up. Scott has it. Hunt in the center, holds onto it. Caroms off one of our players. Scott sends it in. English has it at the top. Wow, what a strike. That was a laser. Looks like it bounced off of Gordon. Or maybe it did. No, I don't know who it bounced off. I just know that was a really nice goal by English. 10 minutes left. Wilson to Elston, up to Bentley, taps it over to English, who sends it forward. Come on, Gordon, get there. Gordon sends it in to Hunt, off the crossbar and out. Oh, that would have been nice. 8 minutes left. Nash with the kick. Penalty kick from just outside the box, it went wide right. 5 minutes left, come on, guys. Hilson to Ellsley, up to Allen, to Perry, up to Scott, who's all alone. He's got options. Crosses it into Hunt. Oh my God, off Murphy and in, 5 minutes left. Can we pull this out? All of a sudden, their passing's gotten a little better. Hunt had an absolute blast, bounced off Murphy, hit the crossbar and went in. Allen with the throw-in to Bentley. Sends it forward, but Truman steps in front of it. Whiteman has it. Over to Reedy. Sends it forward. Nash is there, and he just pushes it wide right. 4 minutes left. 2 minutes left. 4 minutes extra time. Okay, there's 5 minutes extra time. Scott with a throw on their half the field to English. Sends it in to Hunt, to Allen, to Murphy, to Gordon. Oh my God, we absolutely just tied them up. Offside? What the hell? That was offsides? Are you kidding me? Send it up, Hilson. Come on, don't hold on to it. Are you freaking kidding me? Oh, what the? Okay, we're going to come back and look at that. Bentley has it and Davies kicks it out of bounds. Scott with the throw-in. English has it, goes to Hunt, to Allen. Okay. I've set it to slower. So English sends it into Hunt. That's Gordon right there. So he's clearly offsides there. To Allen. Goes to Murphy. Is Gordon offsides there? Does that not count? How is that Is that offside? It didn't look offsides to me. Wins, 5 draws, 13 losses. 124 goals for, 85 against, for a goal differential of 39. We finished with 89 points, second in the league. Losing a heartbreaker to Wimbledon in a game that we lost 5-4 and had 3 goals disallowed. That is going to stick with us for a while. Shania Gordon had a fabulous season for us. 37 goals, 7.52 rating, 21 assists. Joel Grayson had an 80% pass completion. Gordon also had 8 Player of the Match awards. Matty Elston had 8 yellows. Taylor Perry and Josh Meekings had a red card apiece. Well, if we go by appearances, Joel Grayson played every game for us. 6 goals, 11 assists, 3 Players of the Match, a 7.41 rating. Kind of the unsung hero of the squad. A solid presence in midfield. Definitely an upgrade from Ray. Mark Bentley started 46 games for us. 4 goals, 12 assists, 3 Players of the Match, 7.38 rating. Getting better. Needs to improve a little bit in a couple of areas. The low concentration and composure are very troubling, but I think we can work on that. I may look at bringing in some competition for him. Matty Elston, despite all his troubles, had a solid season for us. 45 appearances, 5 off the bench, 2 goals, 7 assists, a 7.07 rating. Tom Ashton. Can't say enough about the guy. 6.90 rating. 44 appearances, 3 off the bench, 26 goals, 19 assists, 3 Players of the Match. Janai Gordon was everything I hoped for and more. 44 appearances, 2 off the bench, 37 goals, 21 assists, 8 Players of the Match, 7.52 rating. His ratings have fallen a little bit. He's gone from 3-star potential to 3-star current to 2.5-star potential, 2.5-star current. I can get another season out of him like this one. I think we're going to be Bill Rickey next year. I want to run away with the league. To come so close and lose it like that is just unbelievable. James Hilson had a solid year for us in goal. 39 appearances, 6.97 rating. Brian Allen had a solid season for us out on the right. 37 appearances, 3 goals, 3 assists, 6.93 rating. Taylor Perry playing next to Joe Grayson. Really came on later in the season. Only 20 years old. Should only get better. 35 appearances, 7 off the bench, 7 goals, 7 assists. Josh Meekings, solid season as well. 32 appearances, 3 assists, 2 Players of the Match, 6.93 rating. Sedwin Scott showed up a little bit less than halfway through the season. 30 appearances, 26 goals, 17 assists, 5 Players of the Match. Everything he was advertised to be in a lot of people's saves. Matt Robinson had a good season as well. 25 appearances, 8 off the bench, only 2 assists, but he was pretty solid defensively in the midfield. Callum Ellerslie, coming in at the January transfer window, 2 assists, 1 Player of the Match, 7.09 rating. Kind of the odd man out, for lack of a better term, is Michael Thelastis. 11 appearances, 9 off the bench, 11 goals, 4 assists. Very capable backup. Keith Hunt, 4 goals in 1 appearance and 4 off the bench. He should definitely get some playing time next year. And comparing him to Cousins, he's just better across the board in the areas where it counts. Well, Marcus Barnes, a fellow Jamaican striker, beat Janai Gordon out for Vanarama National League Player of the Season. Gordon has to console himself by being the Vanarama National top goal scorer. 34 goals, 16 assists, 7.50 rating in national games. One ahead of Barnes. Daniel Udo had 29 goals for Dover Athletic. Players inducted in the best 11, Janai Gordon, Matty Elston, Joe Grayson, and Connor O'Grady were selected to become part of the Enfield Town Proud history. And into season awards. Janai Gordon, player of the season, ahead of Tom Ashton, which is well-deserved. Janai Gordon, signing of the season, 16,000 pounds from Bath City, young player of the season. Tom Ashton at 24. I'm not quite sure he was eligible. I thought that ended at 23. Matty Elson with the goal against Bill Rickey Town in November. Let's take a look at this. Yeah, I remember that. That was a low. Wow. That was a shot from way outside the box. We had more than a few goals like that, but a player like Matty Elson, who really doesn't get a lot of chances, takes it. I'm okay with that. Season review. FA Cup loss in the first round. That was annoying. I really wanted a decent FA Cup run. Runner up in the Vanarama National. Lost in the third round to Fylde in the FA Trophy. I think we should have done better there. Average attendance, 14-13. That's not bad. 35% full for new stadium. Match of the season was our 5-0 thrashing at Barrow. Our moment to forget was our 5-1 loss against Gateshead. Let me check something out here real quick. At Wembley Stadium. Wimbledon brought 35,000 of them. Dynamics-wise, we're doing really well. I don't see Tom Ashton leaving any time in the near future. Elston, Grayson, and Meekings will definitely be here next year as well. Next season, we're playoff bound. Everybody's happy with that. Except those guys? That was strange. Doing an unbelievable job, putting a smile on the face of every supporter. Long may it last. Well, I'll be honest, I'm smiling on the outside. Profile-wise, we're getting better. A few sevens and eights. I am working on my Continental B. I'm studying for my Continental A, I think. I know I started a class in December. We'll have to wait and see. It's not the way I wanted the season to end. I wasn't expecting a playoff run, but once we got there, you kind of really want to do well. And after beating Wrexham, I thought we had a chance. Going 4-0 down and then coming back only to lose it that way. It's just... it's going to leave a mark. For a long, long time.
It's been a couple days since that game happened, and frankly, it hasn't gotten any better. And in fact, listening to it again at the end there, I don't think I've been that dejected since... Good grief, it's been a while. Anyhow, that's a tough way to lose. I've said it before, I wasn't really expecting a playoff push, but it's one of those things that once you get in there, you want to do your best, and clawing our way back from 4-0 down at half, only to lose it, and yeah, I know, we would have tied if that goal had counted, but we'd already come back, that would have been 5 in the half, I think we would have had a chance to at least score. I think I would have rather lost in extra time than lost on an offsides call. That, to me, still looks questionable. And I'll be the first to admit, I could be wrong about that. But it's definitely going to stick around for a while. The nice thing is I can take all that and turn it into next season's push towards the top. I want to be the Billericay next year. I want to jump out to a 16-point lead and then absolutely coast until the end of the season. Automatic promotion. Not have to worry about going through any qualifiers or playoffs or anything like that. That having been said, I'm reasonably sure now at least half my team will be injured by the January transfer window and we'll be fighting for relegation. Frankly, I'd put the odds on that about 6-5 and pick 'em So why not stick around and find out? If you like what you've seen and heard, please hit like, subscribe to the channel for more content. Questions, criticisms, comments, leave them down below. I answer all the comments as fast as I can. My name's FM Jellico. I thank you for watching.